kidding me?
Four things WWE secretly told us on Monday Night Raw. This week's Monday Night Raw saw the build towards WrestleMania 35 be taking up a notch as we approached the final stretch of the biggest show of the year. Every segment was geared towards Mania, and the show really pushed towards the big day. New matches were announced, a title changed hands, and Alexa Bliss confirmed herself as the host of the show. That's not forgetting another excellent promo from Ronda Rousey, and a surprise appearance by Shelton Benjamin as well. It was an excellent addition from WWE's flagship show, but the company also secretly told us four big things in relation to WrestleMania 35, which have got fans very excited for the show. Number 4. Finn Balor and Bobby Lashley will feud till WrestleMania 35. One of the major surprises on Raw this week saw Bobby Lashley defeat Finn Balor to regain his Intercontinental Championship after a distraction by Lio Rush, as the two men got back on the same page. Most people thought that the feud between Balor and Lashley was going to come to an end with this match, allowing Balor to move on and face someone different at WrestleMania. But it seems like the company is planning on having the feud extend until the grandest stage of them all. This makes sense, as it means there'll be some real heat behind the storyline rather than rushing something new with Balor in just 3 weeks. Plus, it adds another singles match on the card that is likely going to be littered with multi-man matches. Hopefully, Balor will choose to bring back the Demon for this match, creating an unforgettable WrestleMania entrance as he likely wins back the title to continue his recent growth. Number 3. Kurt Angle could face a major name at WrestleMania 35. Speaking of WrestleMania 35, another match that hasn't been confirmed but is certainly set to happen is Kurt Angle's farewell match. The WWE Hall of Famer announced on Raw in his hometown that WrestleMania 35 will be his final wrestling match as he plans to retire after the event. Angle's one of the all-time greats in WWE, and it's good to see the company giving him a major spotlight to wrap up his career, as he certainly deserves that. While he can't compete at the same level he used to, he can still put on a great match that will be full of story and have fans emotionally invested. Last year saw Kurt Angle involved in the match of the night as he teamed with Ronda Rousey to defeat Triple H and Stephanie McMahon, so he still knows how to get the job done on the grand stage. Considering how emotional invested the fans will be at WrestleMania, Angle will no doubt put on another brilliant bout this time around. While Kurt revealed he'll retire at Mania, the one thing he kept quiet was who his opponent will be. Although in a YouTube interview with WWE, he did list several people, such as John Cena, AJ Styles, and Samoa Joe. While Cena would be the ideal candidate due to their history together, it seems certain that WWE is going to give him a big name to compete against in order for the storyline to be heavily featured on the show, allowing him to bow out in the biggest way possible. Number 2. Drew McIntyre could face Roman Reigns. Since Roman Reigns made his surprise return to WWE early this year, fans have been wondering what the company has got planned for him on the grandest stage of them all. As WWE hasn't had much time to factor in plans for the big dog, as he wasn't originally expected to be back this soon. However, this week on Raw may have given the best indication as to who WWE is hoping to put Reigns up against, and it seems like Drew McIntyre is going to be the man to step up and face him. The Scottish psychopath brutally attacked Reigns on Raw this week, forcing him to seek medical attention, and he followed that up by destroying Dean Ambrose in a false count anywhere match, standing tall to close the show. McIntyre has been one of the top heels on Raw since last WrestleMania, and sadly, he was starting to cool down the road to WrestleMania, but clearly WWE wants him to be in a big match on the show, and ensured they got tons of heat behind him on Raw this week. Both Vince McMahon and Triple H are big fans of Drew McIntyre behind the scenes, and therefore it wouldn't be surprising to see him get such a big moment at WrestleMania. And it would certainly be brilliant, and certainly physical match between them. If WWE wants to get more people on the card, then they could potentially make it a tag team match involving Dean Ambrose and Baron Corbin, but WWE would be better served having it to be a singles match, having the two men on the outside if that's the way they want to go. Number 1. A possible career versus career match. Another major WrestleMania announcement came on this week's Raw as the expected match between Batista and Triple H was confirmed during their segment, with the added stipulation of the match being no holds barred. Adding that stipulation was a wise idea, as the collective age in the match is over 100. Therefore, it protects both men and ensures that the match quality is much better, with this being more of a brawl than anything else. However, there might be another stipulation added yet, as Batista strongly hinted that he wants this to be his last ever wrestling match and that he plans to make it Triple H's last at the same time. With the Animal seemingly on his way out after this bout, it would be interesting if WWE added a career versus career stipulation, as it would certainly raise the odds of the match if Batista was doing everything possible to end Triple H's career. It will certainly help make the match less predictable, with the stakes higher, the WWE universe is always going to invest deeper